Hey guys, the Black Critic Guy, and welcome to Disney Week, here on the Black Critic Guy channel. Now, for those of you who aren't familiar with the concept of Disney Week, which I don't understand since I've been hyping this up since the end of October, but basically for a whole entire week at the end of November, from November 23rd all the way till November 29th, I will be giving you non-stop videos each and every day, all of them dealing with Disney. And to kickstart Disney Week in style, I'm actually uploading two new videos today. One will be on my other channel, BCG Unplug, where I'm gonna be talking about my top 10 favorite unknown Disney songs. I'll put a link to it right here. Hopefully it's not blocked because it does contain copyright material and I really want you guys to see that list. But if it does get blocked, I apologize. YouTube just freaking hates me, I guess, and just doesn't want Disney Week to start off right. And where's the second video, you may ask? Why, my good sirs and ladies, you're actually watching the second video right this instant. You knew that already. Well, screw you anyway. I thought it was surprising. Yes, this is the second video to kick off Disney Week, and what better way to do that than by discussing the top 10 most underappreciated Disney animated films. The Walt Disney Animation Studios has provided us with a plethora of memorable, timeless, and beloved films, such as The Lion King, Beauty and the Beast, Little Mermaid, Wreck-It Ralph, The Princess and the Frog, and many, many more. And yet, similar to my unknown Disney songs list, because Disney has such a huge library of films, there are films here and there that tend to be forgotten or passed over by the main populace, even though the quality of that film is as great or even better than the films that we've come to love. There are many Disney animated films that are truly underappreciated and don't get the respect and recognition that they deserve. And now we get to count them down here on this list. So, let's stop yammering and get to that list now. Crash landing into the number 10 spot is Lilo and Stitch. Now, I know many of you may not consider this film to be an underappreciated Disney film, considering the fact that it was a modest hit at the box office. It got 3 direct-to-DVD sequels and its very own TV show. Not a lot of the films that I'll mention on this list ever got any of those. But I still personally feel like that it's not as popular or widely known as other Disney films when it truly deserves to be mentioned with them. It's a very touching and charming story about a little Hawaiian girl named Lilo who lives with her sister named Nani after their parents' death and befriends an alien who she'll later name Stitch and their blooming relationship. The story has so much heart to it, and the relationship between Lilo and Nani, Lilo and Stitch, I really felt a strong bond between them, and Lilo and Stitch are just so cute and adorable together. Not to mention that the animation is solid, the action scenes are actually quite thrilling, and it's just an overall great package of a film. And as an islander myself, it brings me great joy to see Disney show some love to Pacific Island life. Narcissistic and hairy as ever is my number 9 choice, The Emperor's New Groove. Though not new and inventive, I mean they didn't recreate the wheel with this one, the film still excels with being very creative and outright hilarious. This film had me laughing so many times. It's a really fun adventure film following a narcissistic emperor who becomes a llama and has to team up with a local villager in order to get his body back to the way it was, with non-stop laughs and memorable characters, especially Yzma and Krunk, who stole the movie from everybody. I mean, come on, let's be honest. When we think of The Emperor's New Groove, we think of Yzma and Krunk more than we think about the llama emperor and the villager. Pacha, that's his name, Pacha. See, I almost forgot his name. If ever you want a good laugh, put in this movie. I promise you, you will not be disappointed. Best Friends Through Thick and Thin is my number 8 choice, The Fox and the Hound. This Disney gem tells the story of an unlikely friendship between, you guessed it, a fox and a hound. From their humble beginnings as playful best friends to full-fledged adults, I guess, in animal terms, who are kind of pitted against each other, which made for some really intense and emotional scenes. And going off of that, the story is very sentimental, with a whole lot of feels at the very end. I mean, if you don't tear up a bit at the end of this movie, I'm gonna assume that you have no soul. Like, I tear up every single time. The characters are very interesting and dynamic, each one having their own unique personalities, and some of them are just ridiculously cute, especially when the fox and the hound are little. I mean, those are some of the most adorable scenes I've seen in a movie. It has some of Disney's finer, more simpler animation in this film. The Fox and the Hound is a solid film about the strength of friendships and makes you really want to reconnect with some of your old friends that you haven't talked to in a long time. And that's why I made it number 8. From adorable friends to adorable couples, we got my number 7 choice, Lady and the Tramp. In my opinion, one of Disney's sweetest love stories about two dogs from different upbringings that fall in love with each other. Now, you may think that this film isn't so underappreciated given the fact that it has one of the most iconic scenes in any Disney animated film, with the two dogs on their spaghetti date and they're eating the same noodle strand and they end up kissing each other. But besides that scene, what else do you remember about this film? See what I mean? It's a very dynamic love story, and shockingly, one of Disney's strongest, because they really develop and flesh out the relationship between the Tramp and Lady. They don't start off liking each other at first, they kind of hate each other, then they slowly build a bond to where they kind of start caring for each other, then they end up together. But it's just so baffling to me that they were able to develop a love between two dogs better than developing a love between a prince and a princess. How shameful is that? The love between Lady and the Tramp is more convincing than the love between Snow White and the Prince, or even Cinderella and the Prince. That is just embarrassing. Regardless of that fact, as a fan of the romance genre, I really enjoyed watching Lady and the Tramp, and if you're a fan of the romance genre, I definitely say give it a watch. Truly Brothers Are the Same is my number 6 choice, Brother Bear. Although not a huge hit with both critics and audiences, I personally felt like Brother Bear had enough good qualities to help it stand out. Like, I loved how they showed old Inuit cultures and treated it with such respect and understanding instead of resorting to cliches and stereotypical Native American culture. And I also loved the bond that they created between the three brothers. I also enjoyed many of the characters, whether they be serious characters or comic relief characters. They all really entertained me and they stood out. And some of them were really strong and well developed, especially our main character Kenai, who goes through a literal transformation to really understand what it means to be a man. The story was also solid, with the whole message about vengeance and its evils and how it never really fixes anything no matter how you see it. And it kind of goes without saying, but I'll say it anyway, because I actually did like the animation in this film. I mean, it just looked breathtaking. Brother Bear is definitely a film that I would recommend people to revisit, because the film does have a lot to offer, and it is, without a doubt, a solid film. Diving to the lowest depths is my number 5 choice, Atlantis: The Lost Empire. Now, I've talked about this film so many times in other videos, so I'll try to keep this one very brief. Made in the period known as the Disney slump, Atlantis was an adventure film following a team of explorers as they search for and later discover the lost city of Atlantis. The characters, although many of them stereotypes and cliche, were still very likable and quite diverse. This is one of the most diverse group of characters I've seen in a Disney film, and honestly has one of the most unique and sadly forgotten princesses, Kida. She is just freaking awesome. Why the hell is she not part of the Disney princess lineup? I mean, seriously, have we forgotten all about this awesome girl? And the animation style in the film was refreshing and unique, being very different from other Disney works before and after. As I mentioned in previous videos before, Atlantis: The Lost Empire is one hidden gem of a film that I feel like more people need to see. So, if you have the chance, I know it's on Netflix, check out Atlantis: The Lost Empire. Heading to the land down under is my number 4 choice, The Rescuers Down Under. This is without a doubt the most obscure and forgotten Disney film of all time, in my opinion. Hell, it is so forgotten that not a lot of people remember that this film came out during the period known as the Disney Renaissance. It came out in 1990. 1990, between Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast, yet nobody remembers Rescuers Down Under. Hell, I'm gonna be honest, I forgot about this film too. And it's a real shame, because this film is an excellent adventure film with some breathtaking animation. I mean, guys, the animation in this film just blew me away. To think that this film came out nearly 24 years ago, yet it still holds up even by today's standards. The journey and adventure was quite thrilling and entertaining and exciting. My eyes were glued to the screen the entire time. And the characters, they're all colorful, they're all interesting, and there is a really menacing character played by George C. Scott that was just perfect casting. He was perfect for that role. To sum it all up, The Rescuers Down Under was a hell of a ride from beginning to end and needs to be seen by more people. Again, this is another film I believe is on Netflix, so definitely go check it out, guys. Elementary, my dear Chabby, is my number three choice, The Great Mouse Detective. It's Sherlock Holmes if he was a mouse. What more do you need to say? That concept alone already sold me. As a kid, I remember loving the crap out of this movie. I would just watch it over and over and over and over again. I was addicted to it. It's actually made by the same guys that would later bring us The Little Mermaid. I just really loved the thrill of the adventure, the charming and entertaining characters, and solid voice work from all the actors, by the way, including Vincent Price, who plays this character named Ratigan, who's probably one of the coolest and creepiest villains I've ever seen in a Disney movie. The Sherlockian feel to the story and world, and finally, the awesome, epic, yet surprisingly scary climax in the clock tower. I mean, damn, that was just brutal. The Great Mouse Detective was just a blast. Pure and simple. Ringing the bells, the bells, the bells, the bells is my number two choice, The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Yet another less mentioned member of the Disney Renaissance. What I love about this film, besides its religious themes that as a kid growing up in Catholicism, I truly related to, was just how vastly different and darker this film was when compared to other films in its era. It took a lot of risk and addressed many serious and dark issues like murder, torture, public humiliation, and even sexual lust. It was a huge risk that Disney took, and sadly, never truly paid off. But it was a risk that I was very happy that Disney took, and showed the potential that Disney had to tell darker stories. The music and score fit perfectly with the tone of the film, and is actually some of Disney's best, with great songs like Out There, The Bells of Notre Dame, and of course, Hellfire! Dark fire! The characters range from being very likable to outright despicable, with Quasimodo being one of the most fascinating characters I've seen in a Disney film. He was just so likable, and I really rooted for him to, you know, be accepted out in the city and to go out and adventure for himself. And then we got the other side of the spectrum, Frollo, who is one of the most menacing Disney villains out there. I mean, I think he was my number one when I did a top five Disney villains. I believe he was my number one choice. I mean, this guy, you talk about despicable. The name Frollo should stand for despicable. Like, if you look it up in the dictionary, Frollo, it should say a despicable person. No offense to anybody out there who's truly named Frollo, but this character, he ruined the name forever for me. Overall, The Hunchback of Notre Dame is a great animated film, and one I can wholeheartedly say is one of the best. And now here we are at the number one spot. And what Disney film could take the top spot from all the others? Well, that film can only be Fantasia. Fantasia, to sound a bit corny, is fantastic. Huh? See what I did there? Oh my god, even in Disney Week? Come on, Tony! Fantasia is just a beautiful film. No, scratch that. It is a beautiful and wonderful experience. It transcends the realm of film to be something even better, even greater. The animation and music complement each other so well, being either gentle and caring and soothing to being dark and ominous and tough. I mean, you talk about Night on Bald Mountain, that shit used to scare me as a kid. No lie. This film is a true work of art and a testament to what great animation can be. I mean, whenever I hear people talk about animation and degrade it as just kid stuff, you know, something to take people's mind off, I would show them Fantasia and ask them to reconsider, because there is no way I would ever degrade Fantasia by putting it in a category with like some run-of-the-mill Warner Brothers cartoon. This is a work of art. This should be admired and appreciated. And yes, I sound pretentious right now, but as a lover of animation, this is one of the films I could say that shows and displays the best animation has to offer. If you love animation, if you love art, if you love music, if you love Disney, you have to see Fantasia. I'm so heartbroken that not a lot of people ever talk about Fantasia. And I was heartbroken that I never fully, you know, gave the recognition Fantasia truly deserves. It definitely should have been in my top 10 Disney animated films list because, guys, Fantasia is without a doubt one of the best Disney films I've ever seen, and a truly underrated one at that. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my list of the top 10 most underappreciated Disney animated films. And I would like to know what you guys thought about this list. Did you agree with my choices? Did you disagree with them? Did you feel like I left any Disney film out? And let me know, what is the most underappreciated Disney film? Comment below and let me know. And now, Disney Week is in full swing, everybody. So stay tuned for all the other videos that will be coming out within the week until the next video comes, guys. If you would like to be a part of the Black Critic crew and not miss a single video in Disney Week, please hit that subscribe button, like this video if you really enjoyed it, and I'm Tony Watt II, the Black Critic Guy. Till then, peace, YouTube.